Hello and welcome everybody to Mind Body Swing. My name is Simon from swingdanceuk.com and this is session number 19. Today we're going to do some sideways breathing. Now, what is sideways breathing? Well, I learned this from a professional ballet dancer. It's a technique that they use, and also a lot of Pilates practitioners I know use this as well. We are going to breathe into our rib cage, and as we inhale, we're going to feel our rib cage expand, and as we exhale, we're going to feel it contract. So sometimes when we breathe into the belly and we push the belly out, we breathe it back. But today we're doing the rib cage. Now, breathe in and feel your rib cage expand. And at the end of the breath in, add a little scoop of the tummy. Think of it in and up. Scoop the tummy in and up. And actually, this is really good for protecting the back when you're moving around. And then as you breathe out, feel it contract and relax. So one more time, breathe in, feel your rib cage expanding to the side, scoop the tummy in and up, and breathe out. One more time, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Last time, breathe in, scoop the tummy in and up, should give you a good posture, and breathe out. Now, why do we do this? Well, it's great for the circulation, it's great for oxygenation, and it's great for purification. So it's a really good way to practice our breathing, especially as dancers, and we want to be able to move around. Thought of the day. As Albert Einstein once said, insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. Now that's a wonderful quote, and I was thinking about it and it made me think of turning our wants into musts, of turning our should-haves into will-dos, and turning our could-haves into did it. You've set your goal. You've decided how you're going to get there. You've got a list of tasks to do. But you know, willpower is very difficult. We spoke about this last week. It's hard to use willpower and discipline to motivate yourself to do something in the long term. Great in the short term. So we want to create habits. We spoke about, we want habits that you do without having to use willpower. You just do it automatically. But how do we get these habits? Well, there's some tricks. First of all, you could do triggers. So triggers is, for example, you set an alarm, or you put on your phone, you set an alarm, or you have a note somewhere that you see it every day and it just reminds you to do something. It could be as simple as if you want to go to the gym, you get your gym clothes out and you put them on the chair in front of you so you see it and it's a trigger to remind you, rather than having them hidden in a cupboard where, oh, you got to go and get them out, it's another job to do. You might set yourself habit stacking, which means you might have a habit of doing something. You might have an early morning cup of coffee, and straight after that coffee, you decide you're going to do whatever it is you want to do. So you stack one habit on top of another. It could be as fun as you go to the bathroom, and every time you come out of the bathroom, you do 30 seconds of exercise. Yeah, it's a great way to stack one habit on top of the other. Write down in the comments what habits you're going to commit to this week, and let's declare them to the world, and let's make them happen. Let's do it, because we have to, we must. We are going to do some movement therapy, and we are going to warm up to Alexander's Ragtime Band by Benny Goodman, and it's sort of Charleston-esque, but we're going to do it with a Lindy flavour. Let's just move. But first of all, check the space around you, make sure you've got a clear space. You know if you've got an injury you need to take care of, you know your own body better than anyone. Yep, so look after your own body, do as much or as little as you feel appropriate for you. Are you ready? Let's begin. Thank you. hammers. One more time, step. Charleston based, but with a sort of a swing flavour. We're going to start with some simple Charleston. Step, a tap, a step, tap. We go. Step, tap, step, tap. Turn around and you can copy me. We go. Step, tap, step, tap. So I step on the left, tap the right, step on the right, tap the left. All these moves that we're doing today, we've actually done a lot of them before and I've explained them in detail, so I'm going to go over them quite quickly. You either need to go back and check some of the previous mind bodies out, or on our membership side, we have what's called the ABC of Jazz, and we have like 50 weeks of wonderful breakdown of all the classic steps you need to pick these moves up. So, two Charleston, step, tap, and I'm going to swing the shoulders. Step, tap, then I'm going to add a little kick. Step, kick, nothing big. Step, kick, step, boom. Two Charleston, step me out on the left, and tap, swing in the shoulders, step, and tap. Add a kick, step, kick, step, kick, step, and plant. So on the last step, I'm going to step down on the left foot. Let's do the last Charleston. Step, kick, step. And instead of tapping the toe behind, I'm going to plant. And notice that my toes and knees are slightly turned out. And I'm going to sink down into the floor. And I'm going to do a lovely move that was shown to me by Mr. Frankie Manning, a dancer from the 1930s, and it's called TikToks. In, out, in, out. Tick, tock, tick, tock. So let's add that on. It's a heel and toe. I go on the heel of the left, the toe of the right, and I turn the toe in of the left and the heel out of the right, and I reverse. So we're gonna go. Knees out to start with. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I drop down, so I'm gonna bounce and go back the other way. One, two. Three, four, five, six, seven. So I'm not doing it every beat, I'm doing it every other beat, so it's on the slow timing. And we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. But now we're gonna do it on every beat, so we're gonna speed up. Oh, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, five, six, seven, eight. From the Charleston. Two Charleston plain, two with a kick, two slow TikToks, two quick ones. Five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Swing the shoulders, two, three, now with a kick. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Last. One, two, three, five, six, plant. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six. The slows. Quick, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now I want to finish with the weight a little bit on my right foot so I can step out and do two more Charleston, step, but this time I'm going to kick across, maybe a little bit higher even, and I'm going to swing the arms in the opposite direction. So I go step, swing, and I'm going to add a windmill, plant, scoop the back foot around, like a windmill going around and around. Let me show you that. So we go step, kick, step, I tuck the left knee behind the right knee, that protects the back knee. I think I scoop as big as I can in one direction, all the way around, and bring it back down. Kick, step, and scoop. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, four, five, staying low, get down. Two, three, swing those arms. One, two, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On the second one, I'm going to put the foot down nice and early, ready for the bee's knees. So let's do that facing you so you can see what it looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plants, I cheat, I come out early, 7, 8. From here, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and quicks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow first. 1, 2, really sink down, hands on the knees. Bring them in, swap the hands over. Bring them out. Bring them in, fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's do that together. 2 Charleston with our kick and our windmill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How are we doing so far? Good. Okay, let's carry on with a kick on the right foot. So from the end of the bee's knees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, drop 8 and come up. 1, 2, 3 and drop. 1, 2, 3 and drop. Kick the right. 2, 3 and drop. Kick the left. 2, 3 and drop. Let's do the 2 sets of bee's knees. First one slow, second one quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Step, touch from the top. Now, those kicks can, of course, rotate. So let me show you, if I do them simple, I go 1, 2, 3 and drop, 1, 2, 3 and drop, or I lean in the direction I want to go, so usually away from the foot I'm kicking, so I'm going to lean and go 1, 2, 3 and drop, use the bounce to come up, 1, 2, 3 and drop. Let me turn around and do that with you. So we go down and 1, 2, 3 and drop, lean, 2, 3 and drop. 1, 2, 3 and drop. 1, 2, 3 from the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, swing the shoulders. 2, 2, 3, 4, add a kick. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 2, 3, into tick-tocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ready, step out on the left. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, into bee's knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and drop. 1, 2, 3, or on the spot. 1, 2, 3, and drop. 1, 2, 3, and drop. Start again. You can choose. Gosh, it's a warm one today. Let's do it. I'm going to let the first 4 8s go by. Fast. some stretching. Well, we've been doing a lot of work on the legs there, so let's do a quad stretch. Pick up one foot, grab hold of the shoelaces. If you need to balance, hold on to your ear, always helps. Or hold on to a wall or someone else. Push the hip forward. So feel the stretch as you push the hip forward, thrust that hip forward, and press the shoelaces into the hand. Push it forward, feel the stretch. Don't forget to breathe and relax. Pick up the other foot, knees together. Hold onto your ear if that helps with the balance. Push the hip forward, feel the stretch in the front there. Push the shoelaces into the hand, get an extra stretch. You have the hand out. You can hold on to something or just your ear, just have the hand down the side. Push, 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 knees together. Pushing it forward. And relax. Let's lift one leg up. Grab hold of the knee and lift it up. Make sure everything's straight and in line. Putting up, putting up, putting up, putting up. Hold it there, balance, balance, balance. And pop it down. Swap the leg, lift the other leg up. Grab hold, lift it up, be nice and tall. Lift it up, check the posture's good, check the alignment's good. Lift up, lift up, lift up, lift up, lift up. And pop it down, let's do that one more time. Swap over, pull it up. Oh yes, we've got this, we've got this. Balancing, are you balancing? If not, start again. Control as you put the foot down, control as you lift the leg up, sort of high as you can without pulling, and then lift up a little bit more. Feel a nice stretch. I usually feel it in the back there. And down. Feet wide apart, widen shoulder width. Bend into one leg, bend into the other leg. Feel maybe a little stretch around the hips. And bend, and bend, and bend. And then we're going to add a small figure eight as you swap sides. So I'm always turning outside towards the knee that's bending. Outside towards the knee that's bending. And rotate. A small figure eight. Maybe I'll start to look behind a little bit as well. And maybe I'll even turn the shoulders a little bit. Maybe I'll hold onto a ball and look over one shoulder. Figure eight with the hips, and around, and around, look behind. You can have the hands low, you can have the hands in the middle, but the main thing is get the figure eight with the hips. You can have the hands up, have the hands up, turn the hips, turn the hips. Calf stretch. Now, if I do it facing you, you'll notice my feet are on two parallel lines. I'm just going to step back on one foot and I'm going to push the heel down and I'm going to bring the weight into the front foot. So let me do that from the side. So I'm standing, feet are parallel. I step straight back with one foot, drop the calf, the heel down, so I'm stretching the calf, weight on the front foot, and you should feel a stretch in the back calf. Sometimes I like to lift it up and put it back down again. It just sort of releases that stretch and allows me to go a bit deeper. Have the weight forward. If you want to add an additional round in the back, it's a bonus, but make sure you keep the weight in the front foot. Oh yes, and then step up and step back with the other leg. Push the heel down. Now some people will do this leaning against a wall, that's fine too. Make sure both feet are parallel and both toes, just check your toes, don't fall over, check your toes, they're both pointing in the same direction, not one out here to the side. Maybe we're push the shoulders behind us this time and lift the arms back. But I'm still getting the stretch in the back calf. You can lift up and come back down if you want. And feel that stretch. Oh yes, I can feel it. And step up. Let's do it one more time. Step back on that first foot. Straight back. Push the heel to the floor. Bring the weight into the front foot. Let's bring our arms behind us this time and lift back, arms behind, shoulders back, nice and tall. Make sure you're nice and straight here, not pushing out to the one side. And bend forward, lean forward, take a bigger stretch, if you need a bigger stretch. And step up, step back again. Roll down into the heel. Make sure the front knee's bent. Hold on to that big beach ball around the shoulders. Keep tall. Try your Sideways breathing. Feel the ribcage expand as you breathe in. Feel the ribcage expand, scoop the tummy up, in and up, and down. One more time for the breath. Ribcage in, scoop in and up with the tummy, and relax. That's today's Mind Body Swing. Thank you so much. Don't forget to pay the price for this workshop. That's give us a like, give us a comment, or share with your friends. That's all we ask. Thank you very much. We're swingdanceuk.com, and we hope to see you again soon. Thank you. Bye.